Alex called me this afternoon.
Well, yeah, what'd he say?
Well, he said to say hello to you guys and that the skiing's great and he misses us and that he's never coming back.
What do you mean he's never coming back?
That's what he said.
Come on, you must have misunderstood.
No.
What were his exact words?
Oh, well, his exact words were, I'm never, ever, ever, never, never coming back.
You sure you didn't say I'm never, ever, ever, never, never coming back, haha? You know how Alex likes to kid?
I don't think he was kidding.
I know how Alex feels. I once left a city and moved to a commune to get away from it all. We had acres and acres of beautiful, unspoiled land to plant and harvest and do our own thing on.
That sounds really nice.
Yeah. Unfortunately, everybody's thing was staying around and getting loaded.
You mean nobody did any farming, huh?
Yeah. There was this one guy who farmed when he was loaded. One day I caught him trying to plant a chicken.
That might be all fine and well with you, Jim, but I know that Alex is coming back.
But Latka, he said that the skiing's great and he's never been happier.
It's all right, Elaine. I know he will be back.
He's breathing clean, fresh air.
He will be back.
And meeting a lot of attractive women.
I'm going to miss him.
So, Nardo's your new shop steward, huh? Wise choice.
What do you mean?
I know how Mackenzie handles people.
Boy, Elaine's right up there, nose to nose with the boss. And our careers are hanging in the balance. The suspense is unbearable, isn't it?
Sure is, Jim.
Well, see you tomorrow.
Take it easy, Jim.
Great news, Bobby.
Why, it better be great news.
The union has agreed to hold a hearing on our grievances.
Yeah, they're gonna subpoena Mackenzie. Oh, and Louie.
Isn't that great?
It ain't gonna do you any good.
Oh, yes, it is, Louie. Your back is against the wall. We've got evidence that is overwhelming.
I'm used to this, Nardo. I am prepared for this Mickey Mouse hearing.
Prepared how?
While you lamos are out there playing in the snow, I'm in here doing a little plastic surgery on the books. According to these records, the Sunshine Cab Company spends as much, if not more money, on maintenance and repairs than any other cab company in the city. Once they get a look at these books, it'll give us time to do a little repairs on the cab so they pass inspection. You see, you guys are dealing with pros here.
Hey, Louie, nobody's gonna be gullible enough to believe your story.
Oh, no? Huh? Hey, Iggy.
Yo.
The Sunshine Cab Company spends more on maintenance than any other company in the city.
Our strike worked. All power to the people.
Well, we'll see, Louie. We'll just see who they believe. Come on, guys, let's get back to the line.
Yeah.
Wait, what concessions did you make?
I'm not allowed to discuss that until after the negotiations. Haven't you ever heard of the Taft-Hartley Act?
Hey, I used to see them on the Ed Sullivan Show. Taft was a goofy one, right?
Hey, guys, I need your opinion here, which is the best aftershave.
Looky-doke.
The best smelling.